Kyle started his career just down the street at MIT, and MIT does a lot of brilliant things, probably most notably tech development. And so given your experience, Kyle, and given all the things you've done in your career, walk us through some of the big challenges in autonomous vehicle technology development.
Well, I'll be the first to say that this is a really, really hard problem. It's perhaps one of the, I'd say one of the first really great applied AI problems. And I think at this point, it's become clear that, you know, building a prototype autonomous vehicle, one where you can put some sensors on a vehicle, integrate a computer in there, and hook everything up so that it works, and get a vehicle to maybe drive around the block without hitting something, is something that now, with the tools available, you know, maybe 5 or 10 talented engineers can do in a few months. But what I think is becoming more apparent now, and we're deep in the middle of, is the difference between a prototype that can drive around the block once and not hit something, and a commercial product that you know, people can entrust their safety to, is enormous. It's several orders of magnitude more complex. It takes more time to design, to develop, to validate, and to collect data on to know that it's ready. And so there are immense challenges.
And as everybody here knows, transportation is just one of the keys to a vibrant economy. And really, the sector itself is incredible. So how do AVs fit into the broader transportation system?
First of all, transportation is huge, right? 3.2 trillion miles traveled in a year. And if you look at what AVs could do to that, we can look at the rideshare industry as sort of a proxy for what it might become. And you know, the rideshare companies today drive less than 1% of those 3.2 trillion miles traveled. So everything you think about rideshare, it's this big trend, it's coming, I know you have some experience in this industry, that's just the tip of the iceberg in terms of, you know, actually having an impact on transportation in the U.S. and the economy at large. But for reasons I'll talk about in a second, AVs have the potential to lower the cost of a transportation service like what you have in rideshare today, to the point where a lot of people are going to flip from owning a car and all the burden and headache that comes with that to using a shared autonomous vehicle in a rideshare network. It's going to make sense economically. It's going to be safer, more basically more accessible and more convenient. It's going to give you that time back that you spend on your commute.
What areas of research and development should be done either in the application, development, or testing and deployment of AV technology? Where, as we in this room, a lot of folks are transportation researchers, where are the greatest needs right now?
The things that are underexploited today are sort of what comes a little bit further out into the future. So there's a lot of focus right now on sensor processing, using the sensors that exist today, and sort of the first versions of these self-driving car systems. What there isn't as much of is thinking about vehicles at a fleet scale. So not just building the first self-driving car, but what happens when you have hundreds or thousands of these in a city and they're all sharing information? Can they look around corners? How can they coordinate to do things like reducing congestion or even acting as infrastructure for one another?
You mentioned that AVs are perhaps the best application of AI. And help us unpack that a little bit. You talked about sensing, but why is that? Why is today unique? And what in the sort of the arc of artificial intelligence and where we are today makes this time special?
Engineers love to work on AI problems because there's some promising results and a lot of innovation happening in the field right now. But what's happening with AV is because there's this huge market opportunity, because there's a huge potential social impact on improving safety. In our case, we're using electric vehicles, so it can be a cleaner form of transportation. All of those things are motivating more people to enter the space and work on these problems. And what I said, or what I think I meant, was this is one of the most impactful applied AI problems you can do today. So people, when they're coming out of these graduate programs and getting these degrees in this industry, now have a place to go where they can take that academic curiosity and fascination with the problem itself and that pure passion for solving tough problems and apply it to a problem that has perhaps one of the largest impacts of any engineering work being done today. And that's a powerful combination. And this only happens maybe once every 10 years or several decades where you have this convergence of high social impact, deeply challenging technology problems, and big market opportunity. And when those three things come together, it creates something really special.